Today's Monday and I try to upload every Monday, but it's been like 2 weeks. I didn't upload last Monday, so I woke up this morning and I was like, I should film something and edit it and what should I do? How about let's color my hair? So I've been getting regular standard highlights up to my roots and the grow out looks like this. And I still want to be blondish, but I'm going to like do a shadow root and bring it down so the ends stay bright. So I have a zone 1 that I'm going to do, a zone 2, and then a zone 3. So there's going to be 3 different formulas that I'm going to use. And before you tag Brad Mondo and all of this stuff, if you watch Brad Mondo, he likes to watch people and react to like their hair coloring things themselves, where they do it themselves. So if before you like tag him in this, just know I have been a licensed hairdresser for 9 years and I have been working as a hairdresser. Right now I'm taking a break because my daughter is kind of a handful. So we are taking a break so I can spend time with her until she goes to preschool. But I do know what I'm doing, and the products that I'm using are all only if you can only purchase it if you're licensed.
Wake it up, please.
Okay, my daughter's awake, so you'll be hearing her and some songs. She wants more of her banana, so let me peel that for her. Here you go. Okay, so I'm going to be using Shades EQ Glosses. I'm going to tone my hair. The reason I'm using Shades EQ, just a gloss, a toner, whatever, it's a demi-permanent hair color, so it's going to fade. It's not going to stay there and be stuck in my hair forever. So as it grows out, so I'm going to apply it to my root, but as it grows out, it'll fade and slowly show my highlights through that as it fades. So if that makes sense, it's kind of more like a graceful fade rather than I'm dyeing my hair black and here's the grow out, you know what I mean? So I'll show you like what I'm going to be using for zone 1. I like to do all the zones separate because it tends to get messy if I don't. I don't know. I can't do it. So I apply a zone, I go back, apply the second zone, and then I'll go back and apply the third zone. So let's get into it. Okay, so for my zone 1, I'm going to be using a 5N. So this is the Shades EQ gloss. It also conditions, my daughter's loud. It also conditions your hair. So you're going to mix this 1:1. So however much you put into this, you need to put the same amount of the processing solution. So 1:1 on these, and I put it in a bowl. And I weigh everything with grams so that it's really equal. I want them all to be very equal. So I'll go ahead and mix that up and I'll show you that. And I'm gonna put a cape on, section my hair. All right, so this is, okay, this is what it looks like. It's kind of like a jelly type of texture, I guess, but really liquidy. You can put it in an applicator bottle instead and squirt it on, but I'm kind of wanting to like melt it down, so I want control over where I'm placing it. And we'll see how I do on the back of my head. So I sectioned it off in the 4 quadrants, just so it makes it easier to tackle one section at a time. And then I did a little triangle section of like my fringe, because I want that to stay bright, so I'll apply it to this part last. So, and I'm gonna apply Olaplex number 1 into my mixture, because this can be applied to any chemical surface in the salon. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that in. It kind of builds the bonds that break in your hair when you do chemical things, so your hair's built up of disulfide bonds. So this kind of goes back in and kind of repairs those bonds, keep your hair healthy. If you are getting your hair bleached, it's like almost crucial to like use Olaplex these days. If your stylist isn't using Olaplex, I would find another one. Anyway, I'm gonna put my gloves on and start applying. We'll see how this goes. It might get a little bit messy. So I have my cape on to protect myself. I put towels all over my counter and on my floor because I have learned many times that when I'm applying toner to my own hair, I get it everywhere. So hopefully I don't ruin my brand new bathroom. And yeah, my husband doesn't know we're doing this either. He's gonna come home from work surprised, either at my hair or at a bathroom mess. So let's see how this goes. So for the back of my head, I kind of just like go by feel because I can't really see the back of my head. So I just hope for the best. And I go around all the perimeters first. So, yeah, and you can feel where you're placing it, so kind of helps. Oh my, I am already dropping it everywhere. So you use the brush and then this side to like put sections in your hair. So I went all around the perimeter and now I'm gonna section it off. You a duck?
You are the mommy duck.
I'm the mommy duck. All right, one section done with zone one. Move on to the next. Thanks, Milo.
Here's your cocky bracelet.
Thank you. Just want to tighten this one down a little bit more so I can see what I'm doing back here because the bump was in my way of my section. That section's done. You want to like keep everything pretty clean and not tangled, so flip it over the head and flip it right back over just so it's not tangled for your next zones. All right, we're gonna be moving to the front now. So I like to pull it tight, make sure I get all the hairs, and then I go around the perimeter of each section. I couldn't really show you in the back because I kind of needed to see also. So make sure to get even all the little baby hairs because that's where you see like lines and stuff where it's like, oh, she dyed her hair. So
you dye our hair?
Yep, you dye your hair. So get the perimeter of each section.
I dye my hair.
You're dyeing your hair? I don't want to dye your hair. You got beautiful hair, Marlo.
No, I dyed it.
Okay. And then pull it tight the other way and get this perimeter. Okay, and then you want to fully saturate each little section. So I like to.
Yeah, this one.
I think I got it in my eye actually. Hold on.
Yay. Uh oh.
We're good. I cried it out just a little bit. are going to section it like this. This is what I did in the back too, but I just didn't want to explain and do the back because that's already that hard. Decide how far you want to go down. So I want to go down kind of far. So I put it on one side, fully saturate, and then I flip it and I do it on the other side. Because you see, it didn't go all the way through. So you want to fully saturate. That's most people's mistakes, is they don't fully saturate and use enough product and they get splotchy because of it.
Hey,
so
I want this, please.
My daughter.
Yeah, open it up.
Okay. Give it to you. Here you go.
Wait, what do you got there?
I'm just dyeing my hair.
Dyeing my
hair? Yep. You're dyeing your hair too? That's great. So I'm kind of making my root color blend in with the highlights. So there's no line anymore. We're kind of smudging out the highlight line. So because I keep hearing that you Gen Zers say side parts aren't cool anymore. So I, to have a middle part, I don't want to have highlight lines. So that's kind of why I'm doing this also. I'm just going to blend, see that line of highlights? I'm just going to go ahead and blend right over that. And then when we put the zone 2 in, we blend those two colors together so there's no line there also. Oh. So I'm picking up like that much product. So what I like also about Shades EQ Gloss is the consistency. A little bit goes a long way. Like it just spreads so nicely. Oh my gosh, I got it on my wall. Gotta hurry and wipe that before it stains. Good thing I got towels. Good. Bradley will never know. Okay. What was I even saying? I don't even know. I honestly don't remember what I was saying. Oh, the consistency. I like the consistency of Shades EQ because it smears nicely and glides nicely, so there's no harsh lines. It's very easy to work with, and the colors come out so gorgeous. They condition your hair like crazy too, which is awesome to have two steps in one. All right, one side done. Let's move on over to this side. Don't forget these little baby hairs here. You want to color them also. Or else you look like a fool! Not really. Okay, so zone 1 is applied to everything except for my front bangs, which I'll do later on. I want to do it for maybe only like 5 to 10 minutes, so I don't want it to be so dark in the front. I'll have a little bit of contrast. My daughter wants an apple, so I'm going to go get an apple, and then I'll show you, what I'm going to be using for zone 2. Okay, for zone 2, I got a new brush and new bowl because I'm going to use the other one to finish off this later, but I'm going to be doing a 6N. So I did a 5N here. I'm going to do a 6N and mix it half and half with a 9V. And remember, you mix it in with the processing solution. However much gloss you put in, you put the same amount of processing solution in. So I'll mix that up and put Olaplex in it, and we'll go with zone 2. Okay, I have it all mixed up. This is what it looks like. And okay, so that's what it looks like. And for zone 2, I'm gonna take the back one a lot. Like I'll take it down pretty far on the back, and then I'll gradually, as I get up to the front, I'm going to bring up like the blondes. So it kind of will go gradually down, if that makes sense. So let's do it. So for this part, because I don't have like the scalp to like smush the product on, I use my hands. And this is why I do it in different sections. It's because it gets messy. And then my hands are all messy when I change, like if I were to do the zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 all at once, my hands are covered. So it just kind of doesn't work that way. So that's what is going on right now. So massage it through, make sure every piece is colored. You don't want splotchy hairs. You want to blend the two zones together. So you do want to overlap them. And I like to get my fingers and really mush them together. So this 5N and then the lighter creates like a merge together when you mix them together. So like it'll be dark, a little bit lighter, and then the lightness will come through. So you do want to like mush them together. You want to really get it through the whole section. Make sure every hair is saturated, or else it's splotchy. You can also do this on damp hair, and it kind of makes it a more transparent looking color. I chose to do dry, clean hair today, just so it'll last a little bit longer on me. So my whole life, I grew up as a blonde, and then like 8th grade, started getting darker hair, and then I went to beauty school and bleached the crap out of my hair. And I've gone through like different phases. I went red and black and all this stuff through beauty school, but for the most part I have stayed a blonde. And during the whole 2020, I did not dye my hair at all until I think it was November. So I had a lot of regrowth in my, and I realized like my natural hair is pretty dark. So I was used to the dark, but then like I was going crazy, like I don't feel like myself if I'm not a blonde. So I called up my hairdresser. We got a full head of tiny highlights everywhere and was super blonde, and it's fun. I really liked it, but something has changed within me. I don't feel like a blonde anymore. I don't know if it's like because I'm old now. I'm not old. I'm only 28. But like, I don't know what has changed inside of me. I missed my dark natural hair. So I went and got my highlights done one more time, so I did it twice. And then this last time, as the regrowth was coming in, I was like, do I want to go get it colored again, or do I want to go back to my natural? So that's kind of what I'm doing today. Going back to my natural-ish, but also leaving the ends blonde. I like that pandemic grown out quarantine look, okay? I am making a mess. Absolute mess. The mid-shaft, which is this zone too, is always so messy for me. Even on clients, it just like goes everywhere. I don't know if it's a me problem or if other stylists have this issue, but yeah. And because I'm doing it myself, I am aware that it might be a little bit splotchy on myself. I would recommend going to a stylist where they can like actually see your whole head and see what they're doing. Don't do it on yourself. I only am because I'm confident, because I've done this thousands of times on people. So doing it on myself is, it's different, but like also the same. So just go to a stylist. They can do the colors to your head of hair. Everyone's head of hair is different. Everyone's hair history is different. So just go to a stylist. I'm only doing this myself because I'm not doing hair for a little while, and I have a lot of hair products and toners that are just sitting there. So I would have gone to my hairdresser. Shout out to Hillary. But I mean, if the product's just sitting here tempting me day after day, might as well use it. Why do I do that voice? I don't know. Also, I'm not neglecting my child. She has made me go get her a banana and then another banana. She ate two bananas. And then she asked for an apple, so I had to stop it and go get her some stuff. So don't worry. She's being taken care of. And then she asked for some makeup, so I gave her some makeup. And she's preoccupying herself by making a mess. An absolute mess in my carpet. My husband is going to be so happy. Yesterday, so she likes to rub my blush around, and then she put it in the carpet yesterday, and my husband was like, do not give her makeup anymore. And I said, okay. But it keeps her busy, and I just vacuum it up. It's fine, right? It's fine. Everything's fine. All right. Now, time for the last zone. Ooh, 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 ooh. All right, for the last zone, I'm going to be doing 10 GI, so it'll have a little bit of gold into it. The gold makes it look brighter. If you use too much cool tones, it just looks dull. So I'm doing a 10 GI with a 9M. So I'm going to mix those in a bottle this time because I can just squirt it on the ends and massage it really good. I don't have to be really precise like I did with the other zones. So I'll mix that up, put Olaplex in it, and then we'll just put it on the end. And then last minute, as I'm mixing, I decided to add a 10P as well, pearl color, so. All right, so it's mixed up in here. Don't be alarmed, I'm not putting orange on my hair. Hair color has to process, it goes through oxidization, so it always, like if you see your hairdresser mixing a color and you're like, why are you putting red in my hair? They're not, okay? Unless you specifically asked for red. They're not putting red in your hair, so. Oh my gosh, I am making a mess everywhere. I'm gonna spray the ends of my hair just to make them a little bit wet, so it glides just a little bit better. Okay, can you deal with that? Oh my, I am making a huge mess. It's fine, it's fine. It's fine. Nothing is permanent. Ah, I dripped it on my foot. This gets so messy. I'm so glad I put towels on the ground. I'm almost done and we'll get one, okay? Okay, I will. Don't touch that. Don't touch that. Don't touch that. Thank you.
What's this?
That's the hair color.
And what's those?
That's the hair color. Please don't touch it, okay?
Well, I smell it.
You smell it? Does it smell good or bad?
Yeah, I smell it.
Does it smell good or bad?
Smell good.
It smells good. That's good. Maybe you're a future hairdresser. Gotta massage it in there because there's always like inside sections of the hair that don't get touched a lot of the time, so you have to really get it in there. So once it's applied to all my hairs, I will mush it all around and apply it everywhere. If you just do that, but then you open up the hairs, you can see like what didn't get touched. You gotta actually, I use like my thumb and just squish it all over. Get it in and covering every single hair. I thought this would go so much faster. I don't know what I was thinking. Okay, last thing I'm gonna do is the front pieces. So I think I'm going to apply at the roots the formula that I applied on zone 2. So not the darkest, but the second darkest I'll apply. And then I'll apply what's left in the bottle to the rest to brighten that up, kind of blend that down, but also still be lighter than the rest of my hair. Okay, now I wait for that to process. Total processing time from like finished would be about 20 minutes. So like, I know the roots have been on for probably an hour now because that's what I started with. But once the ends are on, I start the timer for about 20 minutes. And yeah, then I will put on the second step of Olaplex. So you rinse it out completely, put in Olaplex number 2, which only professionals can buy, so go to your hairdresser. And then you let that sit for like 5 to 10 minutes, and then you go ahead and shampoo and condition like normal. So I'll see you later. I'm gonna clean up a little bit. It's a bit of a mess. Okay, so I washed it and dried it and put more makeup on because it got all over. Anyways, I really like it. It's exactly what I was picturing. It's basically my natural hair color, which is really hard to match. So as you can still see highlights throughout, but they're very subtle and everything just got blended really well together. And I'm really liking it. I think it'll be fun to do hairstyles with. I think it turned out gorgeous, gorgeous, baby. I'll curl it too, because curling it helps you see the different tones in the hair. So I'll curl it and give it a little dimension so you can just see all the different tones, but I really like it. All right, so that's it for my tutorial today on making my hair a more natural looking color, and I am so happy about it. So go ahead and give this video a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel. I try and upload every Monday, but it turns out every other Monday with my schedule right now. But, oh my daughter's shaking the camera right now. Anyways, you can follow me on Instagram to watch reels on short, quick hairstyles. I post a lot about my daughter. You can hear the super simple songs. playing in the background. Anyways, thank you for watching. My Instagram is at Kim and Lo. Honey, it's okay. It's at Kim and Lo.
Hey, Mom, I want to hold you.
Okay. And anyways, thank you for watching. I will hopefully see you next week.